We're in the land of famous cathedrals and beautiful old world castles perched high atop the Alpine peaks. And we welcome you to Lausanne, Switzerland, on the shores of Lake Geneva, as we begin our coverage of the 1997 World Figure Skating Championships. And we are inside the Mallet Ice Center, along with Leslie Visser, Peggy Fleming, and Dick Button. I'm Terry Gannon. We're getting set for the pair's short program as we kick off our coverage. And on the ice first, the reigning U.S. champions, Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon. And with their new title comes newfound confidence and a chance to take it to the next level.
It's power. You know, we're going to go out there and we're going to skate. We're going to put you on the end of your seat and leave you there.
Short program's always intense no matter where you go. It's a do-or-die situation. There are eight elements and you have to do them all or else you get a deduction. And that's just the way the story goes.
Kyoko Ina, Jason Dungeon, United States of America.
Well, for 3 years, they were the silver medalist at the U.S. Championships. And this year in Nashville, they broke through with the gold medal. Last year, they finished sixth at these World Championships in Edmonton. They believe that they have a chance to stand on the podium. Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon.
The music, Kodo by Kodo.
And they've packaged this short program so well. The costumes, the music, and choreography really emphasize their best qualities, power and excitement. Very nice unison on these side-by-side combination spins.
Good back position on him there. That's much improved. A double split twist. Remember, there are eight elements that are required through these events.
This short program accounts for one-third of the overall score. Skaters have already been on the ice competing here in Lausanne. They had to qualify to get into the short and long programs.
And now the crucial element of this short program comes up right now in their side-by-side triple toe loops. And there's their preparation. They did them. That's great.
A reason why side-by-side triple toe loops are so difficult for pair skaters is that they work more on the lifts and the pair spins than the single skaters do, and as a result, they're not as accomplished in that area. That's why it's tough for them to do these and also make them simultaneous with each other.
Right, the timing has to be so perfect.
On this next lift, it's a star change with a reverse exit. Watch the change both in the edging as well as in the rotation in the middle of the air. Here it is. Turning, star lift. Now watch her change, move, and in and out.
Very nice, smooth transitions. Ending, it just glides.
Well, that was a very neat and clean program, and the fact that they were able to pull off all of the very difficult elements stands them in very good stead in this competition, because it is this part of the competition which will clear out many of the pairs.
24-year-old Kyoko Ina and 29-year-old Jason Dungeon.
And here's a look at their side-by-side triple toe loops. Here, their inside edge and tapping the toe. Up they go, three turns in the air. A little off on the landing on their timing, but very well done.
And this, look at this now, this lift. First, she goes up into the air in a so-called star lift. could be a little more arch, but look at the turning ability. Now watch as she switches as he switches hands and she switches her body. That's a very tough position. And now the dropout. Look at this. That's a tough lift and very well done. I think you have to remember the fact that if it doesn't come quickly, you just have to stick with it in this sport, and that eventually it will come if you have the dedication as well as the talent.
Well, they've had a lot of perseverance, especially in the U.S. National Championship, finished sixth at the Worlds a year ago. Now, there are two sets of marks during the short program. First for required elements, 5.3 up to 5.7 for Ina and Dungeon.
Second mark, 5.6.
Skaters having to complete those eight required elements. Second set of marks for presentation, 5.4 up to 5.7, the range for the Americans, Ina and Dungeon. And hello again, everyone. I'm Terry Gannon. We're glad you're along with us as we kick off our coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard here on ESPN2. We'll be here and over on ESPN throughout the week, and also on ABC Sports Thursday night for the men's finals. And then Saturday night is the ladies' finals on ABC. Americans Todd Eldridge and Michelle Kwan trying to defend their world championships here. And we have 17 and a half hours of coverage in all from Lausanne, Switzerland. Well, here in the pair short program, we have already seen the reigning U.S. champions, Ina and Dungeon. And Peggy, in a little bit, we get a look at the pair that held that title for the past three seasons, Jenny Mino and Todd Sand, and they're also the reigning world bronze medalists.
Well, Terry, this last month has been something of a disaster for Jenny and Todd, the loss of their national title, and then a withdrawal from the Champions Series final because of injury has been devastating to them. They came into the season wanting to show their hard work has paid off, especially with the addition of side-by-side triple toes, an element that every world medalist has to have these days. It's been a rough week of practices here for them, but their special communication on the ice is still there, and they want a spot on that podium.
But it won't be easy for Mino and Sand here in Lausanne, because there's a wide open, very deep field here in the Paris competition, headlined by the Germans, Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Steuer. They have won four major international competitions this year, and all of them over the reigning world champions, Marina Yeltsova and Andrei Bushkov of Russia. And Dick, the Russians or former Soviets have absolutely owned this competition. They've won 27 of the past 32 World Pairs titles.
That's a pretty good run.
That's not bad.
Well, you know, that run continues. The tradition of that skating continues here as three of the top four pairs are Russian. Yeltsova and Bushkov, Kazakova and Dmitriev, and Berezhnaya and Sikarulidze. Now, Berezhnaya and Sikarulidze represent the youthful elegance of the pure Russian classical pair skating style. And perhaps their story suggests why that Russian tradition continues so strongly. See, a year ago, she and another partner were skating side-by-side flying camels when his blade pierced her skull. After two brain operations, she had to learn to speak again and walk again, let alone skate. But she couldn't imagine doing anything else. And with the support of her new partner, she's been the inspiration of these championships.
And Dick, as you know, there are eight required elements here in the pairs short program that the skaters must perform. And Peggy, one really jumps out as maybe the key to the competition.
It sure does. It's a side-by-side jump. You can either do a double or a triple jump, but when they're triples, they're doubly difficult. And when you miss it, it's devastating to your chances of getting on the podium.
Christy Sargent, Chris Wirtz, Canada.
This short program, a part of this competition that the skaters just want to get through without making mistakes. Well, here on the ice, from Canada, the silver medalist, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz.
And they open this short program with the most difficult element, the side-by-side triple toes. This probably makes them the most nervous through this whole routine. Here they go for the entrance of the inside three. Very nicely done.
You know, the tough part is if everybody wins or does all the elements, it's going to be much more difficult to decide who wins the overall event.
Right.
The music, 3 hours past midnight. A double split twist. By the way, that's only a double, and that's the requirement. In the long free program, you'll see split triple twists.
This is their spiral sequence, one of the other elements. remind me of Underhill and Martini from Canada, who won the World Championships in 84. Especially Christy, she really has Barbara Underhill's appearance.
That's a very hard switchover in the middle of that lift. One of the requirements, side-by-side spins. This is a camel sit spin, change sit. She has a very good back position.
Three times Sargent and Works have been the silver medalist at the Canadian National Championships, and Christie's really had to make a lot of sacrifices for their skating careers. She has a young daughter who for some time she had to leave behind in Edmonton, Alberta, and move to Quebec where Chris trained. But now she has her daughter with her, and she's together with Chris. Much happier now.
Very nice.
23-year-old Christy Sargent and 27-year-old Chris Works of Canada. Their performance here in the pairs short program. Remember, there are three teams from the U.S. competing here, though, in the pairs. There's one of them. Jenny Mino and Todd Sand, they're getting ready to skate next when we return to Lausanne. The 1997 World Figure Skating Championships are presented by MasterCard, the official card of the World Figure Skating Championships. We are back at the Mallet Ice Center here in Lausanne, Switzerland. As the pair short program continues, there's a look at Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz of Canada. Following their performance here in the short.
Chris Wirtz, Canada. First mark, 5-0, 5-2.
Now look at these side-by-side triple toes. Good, neat, clean, very high. You know, all of the pairs so far are doing wonderful side-by-side moves.
Again, two sets of marks, the first for required elements, and the range 5.0 up to 5.5 for Sargent and Wirtz. They were seventh at the Worlds a year ago in Edmonton, and the presentation marks that they await.
You know, I always sound a little surprised when they all do it, make those triple jumps. They lose them so often that it's nice to see them make them.
And now getting ready to skate the three-time U.S. champions. They've been forced to deal with a disappointing second-place finish at Nationals and Todd's back injury. They tell us they're still very optimistic about their chances here in Lausanne.
It's been a little difficult because, of course, I worry about him and he's in pain. But we're trying to look at it and remember that it goes along with pair skating, and I think a lot of the guys have had bad backs, and we try to remember that. And, you know, we've been skating pretty well, and so we're just trying to do what we do and not think too much about the back.
Well, they relinquished their title at the U.S. Championships in Nashville, have dealt with a lot of adversity, but they're ready to try to gain back some of that momentum. Jenny Mino and Todd Sand.
Well, they've had very shaky practices all week. Now they need to focus and complete all these eight elements.
The music, Chopin's Fantasy Impromptu. And this, their most difficult moment.
Oh, good for them. Yeah. Todd has worked very, very hard to get his triple toe loop more consistent, and it's really paying off tonight.
Very good position, beautiful, beautiful arch on his back. This pair has a great sense of romantic style. It's very finished. They work well together. They have really been marvelous in their unison.
Over program at the U.S. Nationals, of course, that was their downfall. They both fell on the ice towards the end of that program. And as Peggy mentioned earlier, they've had troubles all week here in Lausanne, but so far, so good.
And their beautiful line that they have is exquisite.
Look at the unison here. That's very hard. And far too often, it's rarely seen. The one-arm aspect of that overhead was its difficult element.
Their final element, the forward inside death spiral.
That's an exquisite position.
Gorgeous line. Very clean. Beautiful program.
Well, you know, it's exceedingly nice to see them just get over the mistakes and the disaster at the national championship.
Well, they really focused on this short program. Good for them.
A lot of fans here for Jenny Mino and Todd Sand. They've dealt with so much adversity, but nothing but smiles here in their short program. We'll be back. Along with our coverage on ABC Sports Thursday night and Saturday night of the men's and ladies finals, coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard continues Thursday at 12:30 a.m. Eastern Time, 9:30 p.m. Pacific on ESPN2 with the men's short program featuring Todd Eldridge, the U.S. and world defending champion. Then, on Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, tune in to ESPN for a three-hour special. We'll have the ladies' short program, the original and free dance, and you'll also see the gold medal performances in both the pairs and men's competition. We're back with the scores of Jenny Mino and Todd Sand. They had the crowd on its feet at the end of their program. And here are their required element marks. They're very good.
Second mark. 5-9, 5-5, 5-8.
And here's a look at their side-by-side triple toes. They're very focused, very straight in the air. A little shaky on Todd's landing, but he held on. He wanted to do that.
Peggy, their coach, John Nix, along with them, the second set of marks, 5.5 with the 5.8. And they are now in first place over Ina and Dungeon here in the short program. And here's the remaining U.S. pair. American bronze medalist Stephanie Stiegler and John Zimmerman. They tell us that while most skaters dread the short program, they're looking forward to it.
The short, I think, suits us really well because John gets to be, like, almost not wild.
Dramatic.
And
flamboyant, as I want to be out there on the ice. And Stephanie,
I can be a little bit more serious and think about what I'm doing, but yet, like, almost...
She still plays her part.
We still play
each other's part in this program as the man and woman
out
on the streets dancing. And it's a very violent type of program. And we both know our roles and our characters well. And just try to do the best we can with it.
Mm-hmm. Their second season together, their first trip to the World Championship, 17-year-old Stephanie Stiegler and 23-year-old John Zimmerman.
The music, Argentine Tango, it lends the tension and the speed to this program.
Their coach, Peter Oppegaard, choreographed this. They open with side-by-side triple toes. Oh, he only did a double. Steady lift, very controlled. Mm-hmm.
watch Stiegler and Zimmerman skate. We should point out that the qualifications for the Olympics and next year's World Championships have changed. It is not only the top pair that will be considered, but all three of the teams from America. Oh. And that hurts.
Now, that kind of a fall along with the miss is going to knock them out of any hope to getting into the top rank. But the important thing about this pair is to look at the tension, the speed, the energy, the vibrancy, and the excitement that they have. They have great potential.
Getting back to what we were saying, Dick, very important how they finish, because it goes to how many teams the U.S. can send to the Olympics and to the World Championships next season.
Oh, and he just tripped again.
These are really difficult moves. This is a tough program.
It not only has tough steps in it, but the tension and the drama that they have to add to it to relate to this music. This is their final move, the forward inside death spiral.
Well, no matter what it is, they're a very exciting pair and they have enormous potential.
Certainly the pressure of competing in their first World Championships will be getting to them just a bit here in the short program. Stephanie Stiegler and John Zimmerman will be back. Well, certainly a disappointing short program for Stephanie Stiegler and John Zimmerman. They're alongside their coach, Peter Oppergaard.
Look at this. As they move in this step, these complicated, intricate steps, right there. Oh, what a step. I mean, really disaster point. It's like welcome to the club. Everybody does it once, and she'll never take that step again without remembering it. It's a very, very difficult experience for her.
And they were so excited when they arrived here, and they've been here for days. There are a number of family members on John Zimmerman's side that are in attendance to watch them. Now, you wonder if you arrive here so excited, and after you've been here for a number of days, it starts to wear on you a little bit.
Well, this is their first World Championship, so it's a very exciting character-building event for them.
Mm-hmm. Right now, two American pairs atop the standings early on here in the short program. Mino and Sam lead Ina and Dungeon. And the required element marks for Stiegler and Zimmerman, they still await those at this point.
4-7, 5-0.
And there they are in the second set of marks for presentation as well for 17-year-old Stephanie Stiegler and 23-year-old John Zimmerman.
Thank you. Reprise de la compétition dans.
In a very wide open field, if there is a favorite here in Lausanne in the pairs competition, it may very well be the German pair, Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stoya.
As they skate, watch their edging. It's strong, clean, their moves very unpretentious. It's straightforward performances, and this, their most important element. Very good.
Beautiful. In the warm-up, they were both landing them very consistent.
Now, last year, they were the silver medalists at the World Championships. Marina Yeltsova and Andrei Bushkov of Russia, still to skate, are the reigning world champions. But this is the pair that defeated them four times this season. The only time they lost was at the European Championships.
The music is a question of you. And my question is, does it help them? watch the one-handed aspect of this.
Very nice position in the air with her legs together.
A spiral combination of steps, serpentine shape. Beautiful position.
Very nice positions in this pair. Combination spin, good speed. Very well done.
That was a very clean performance from beginning to end. They're very straightforward skaters. I mean, there's no pretension or nothing phony about them. No excessive movement.
Right now, Mino and Sand of the U.S. lead the competition here in the short program, but we'll have the scores of Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stoya of Germany when we come back. We're back in Lausanne, Switzerland, the Paris short program. Dick, you asked about their choice of music. I want to know about Ingo's choice of pants. How uncomfortable would those things be on the ice, huh?
And here's a look at their hip lift that they did. Very nice control, good position in the air, nice transition into that beautiful leg position, and a nice flowing exit. Very confident.
And the one disappointment this year, you mentioned it, their second place finish at the European Championships, but Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stoya now with their first set of marks, 5.7 to 5.9. Very good, the best that we have seen.
Incidentally, they were in third place by the Great Britain judge.
Mm-hmm. And their second set of marks for presentation, 5.7 up to 5.8. So they take the lead over Mino and Sand right now. Well, here is a pair that has loads of talent. When they are on, they are very, very good, but they have been somewhat inconsistent since getting together in February of 95, Oksana Kazakova and Artur Dmitriev of Russia.
And their music, the overture to 2001 by Strauss, also called Thus Spake Zarathustra.
And this music sets the stage perfectly for this pair. They're powerful, dramatic, and very exciting.
But of course, the main point for them is to get over this next required element, side-by-side jump. There's triple toes, and he only did a double. Looked like she did a triple, but that can be quite an expensive miss for him. This a split double twist. Look at the height he gets up. Really marvelous.
And they have this crowd very excited already. And this number is only going to be 2.5 minutes long. Very nice position in this lift.
That's a favorite Tamara Mosbina move.
She is unbelievably flexible.
This is a new short program this year for Kazakova and Dmitriev. A year ago, they won the European title in their first season together. This year, they didn't even make it to Paris. They were fourth at the Russian National Championships and had to finish second in the Champions Series final just a couple of weeks ago to make the Russian world team.
Thank you. everybody is very much for them doing well. He has established an astounding record being the Olympic pair champion, and now performing with another partner makes him a very rare pair skating personality.
Oksana has very big shoes to fill, and I think she has improved so much this past year, and she's really rallied to this challenge.
Well, they certainly have the audience on their side.
They are wonderful to watch.
He has been one of those skaters who really has trouble maintaining his enthusiasm for this sport. He's, after all, 29 years old, and keeping up with the rigidity of the rules and concept in the younger skaters must be very difficult for him.
Along with our coach, Tamara Moskovina, one of the pairs that many people felt not only had a chance to garner a medal here at the World Championships, but perhaps even to vie for the overall title. It's been an up-and-down relationship for them on the ice since they got together in February of 1995. All the expectations that they have tried to meet, and it's very high. Tough to meet those.
He really represents an enormously romantic, big style of Russian dance.
And Dick, here are the first set of mixed required elements, 5.3 up to 5.6. And you can tell by the reaction of the crowd, they're lower than, well, our tours expected. Look at the face on him.
Well, maybe they didn't recognize the fact that he only did a double.
And the second set of marks, 5.6 up to 5.9.
5.9, 5.9. Thank you.
One of the things you'll notice about this program is their fast, very crisp-like moves. It's almost festive. And he's, oh, pretty good, except for that little spot on the back.
Remember, this short program accounting for one-third of the overall score. Finals of the pairs. You can catch that on ABC. Thursday night beginning at 8 Eastern time.
Oh, wow, did you see that ice?
That was wonderful.
As Yeltsov and Bushkov skate, Wurzel and Stoya are in the lead right now, ahead of Americans Mino and San, and Kazakova and Dmitriev, and Ina and Dungeon of the U.S. are in fourth.
Good speed on these spins, spin combination.
One of the things I've noticed about them is that they seem to have almost risen above their technique. They've gotten secure enough with it that you just kind of feel that they're now floating through it and letting it and using it to create their choreography.
All right, they look very comfortable out there. You're not nervous that they're going to miss something. And that confidence comes along with being a world champion.
Nice straight line footwork. It's almost as though they're having fun with it and playing with it. That's nice to see. Well, it's certainly going to be interesting to see how the judges place this vis-a-vis Wurzel and Steuer.
Wurzel and Steuer lead right now ahead of Mino and Sand. We'll have the scores, though, of Marina Yeltsova and Andrei Bushkov, the reigning world champions, when we return in a moment to Lausanne. Ice Center here in Lausanne, Switzerland. Yeltsova and Bushkov awaiting their scores after their performance in the short program.
And look at the side-by-side triple toes. Now, watch them. She landed fine. He just hung on to it. Didn't touch down. That'll be a very, very minor, I think, deduction.
And this is a look at their double twist. Nice split in the air, almost parallel to the ice while she was rotating in the air.
Now, they've accomplished so much against very tall odds. Not only the financial situation in Russia, they still live and train in St. Petersburg, but also without the full support, really, of the Russian Federation. They think they've been written off at times. Their former coach, Igor Moskvin, encouraged them to quit at one point, but here they are, the reigning world champions. Let's see what their scores look like. The first set of marks for required elements, 5.6 up to 5.8. And for presentation, 5.7 up to 5.9, the range. And with those marks, they are now unofficially in second place, right behind the leaders from Germany, Wurzel and Steuer. And here are the four-time and reigning French national champions who really burst onto the international scene a year ago when they placed third at the Europeans. And we'll try to improve on their 11th place finish at the Worlds last year in Edmonton. Sarah Abitbol and Stefan Bernadies.
Nice height on that double twist. Very light in the air.
They have a wonderful sense of energy and speed. A little loose around the edges, but very energetic and very... Wow! They hit that one too.
Very nice, side-by-side, triple toe loops.
And look at the smiles. I think that relieves them a lot.
This is a very tension-filled 2.5 minutes for all of these skaters.
Comes down to a rather nice closed position there.
Yes.
In the air. When I said earlier, loose around the edges, what I really meant was that they'd have little sense of overall style or togetherness, but wonderful energy.
They have a lot of personality in the choreography that they do in their programs.
There's nothing stilted or restricted about their skating.
Really play to the crowd a lot, too. Straight-lined footwork, one of the eight elements in this short program.
Of course, completing the eight required elements, a big part of this short program, but remember, presentation mark, the second set of marks, just as important. Wait 50-50 here in the short.
The final move, a death spiral.
I like her position looking up to the ceiling. Very nice arch.
Well, that was a good one for them.
Very refreshing.
Yes. We've seen some wonderful pair skating in this short program tonight. So frequently, it's disaster from beginning to end. But this was a nice evening.
Well, they finished 11th at the World Championships a year ago. They'd love to at least get a top 10 finish. The short program, certainly a good one for Sarah Abitbol and Stefan Bernadies. Still to come
Milena Beresnaya and Anton Sihorodnidze of Russia when we come back. Welcome back to Lausanne. Abbott Bowl and Bernadiz, the reigning French national champions. They have to be thrilled with what they did on the ice here in the short program.
And here's their side-by-side triple. Tolips, they did so well. They're very close together, very tight in the air, nice controlled landing, and they were very relieved to have that over with.
And their first set of marks for required elements. There they are for Abbott Bowl and Bernadiz, 5.1 up to 5.6 the range.
Oh, and look at what that does to the marks. Look at what that does to the placement.
Yes, you look at the second set of for presentation, 5.2 up to 5.7. That places Abbott Bowl and Bernadiz in sixth. Ina and Dungeon moving up to fourth behind Mina and Sam now.
Sur la glace, on the ice, Elena Beresnaya, Anton Sikarulidze.
So a reshuffling in the top five here in the pair's short program with only one pair left to skate. And what a story this pair is. A year and a half after suffering a major head injury, she had two brain surgeries, had to learn to talk again. Elena Beresnaya here at the Worlds, her new partner Anton Sihorodnidze.
She has wonderful arms that never really seem choreographed. It makes every move larger than life. And they're opening with side-by-side triple toes.
Oh, very nice ones too.
They had good speed on the exit of those jumps. That's a nice quality.
Since the accident, he's become her support. And look at the height he supported her into there.
She almost delays it. She does that split and holds that air. It's wonderful. They are such an unusual pair to be so equal in their power and their body line.
And her courage is something you have to marvel at, to go back on the ice and compete after receiving an injury on the ice and having two brain surgeries and coming back from that.
Oh, very inspiring. Their unison is very nice. They just flow the same way.
Beautiful and difficult.
Elena and Anton finished third at Europeans this year in Paris, and that was after a second-place finish at the Russian Nationals, where they beat, among others, Kazakova and Dmitriev, who we have already seen skate.
That descent was one of the few less attractive moves, but the position at the bottom, very nice. Such elegance and line and sort of gentility to their skating. I think tonight was just a touch off the top of what they can do. And remember, they've been skating together really a very short period of time. So it's really magnificent to see the pair develop this fast, this quickly.
And every competition for her is a gutsy one. Elena Beresnaya and Anton Sihorodnidze of Russia. We'll see if they can shake up the scoreboard after this message. Will have their scores. Don, Elena Beresnaya, and Anton Sihorodnidze of Russia awaiting their scores, along with their coach Tamara Moskvina. And Tamara looking up to see them. The required element marks, they're very good, Dick.
Oh, look at that. They're in third place at this point.
Along with the presentation marks, you're right. They move up into third place
Berezhnaya and Siha Radlicha right ahead of Mino and Sand, and then Ina and Dungeon. That's a heck of a short program for the Russians. So as they did a year ago in Edmonton, Vertsel and Stoya lead after the pair's short program. But remember, the Russians came back to win. Yeltsova and Buzhkov, see if they can do it again this year. Mino and Sand ahead of Ina and Dungeon, two spots in the top five for the American teams. The other U.S. teams, Stiegler and Zimmerman, in 13th place. They'll learn from their first trip to the Worlds. And you can catch the Paris Championships Thursday night beginning at 8 Eastern time on ABC. Our coverage here on ESPN2 continues tomorrow night at 12:30, 9:30 p.m. Pacific with the men's short program. Peggy Fleming and Dick Button, I'm Terry Gannon. So long for now from Lausanne.